Wednesday was a wild scene, not only for those in America, but the world. We've seen white supremacists try to threaten the very foundation of democracy by storming the Capitol. It was like a scene in a movie, a surreal moment in history, incited by one man, Donald Trump. You may be asking yourself right now, what does this have to do with my channel, a basketball channel? As we've seen in the bubble last season, basketball and politics go hand in hand. The NBA and its players always respond to the social injustices that occur in America. We've seen this with their courts dedicated to BLM, their jerseys dedicated to issues within America, and their constant interviews bringing focus to Breonna Taylor, Ahmaud Arbery, and George Floyd. Even after the riots on Wednesday, the players stood together in unity and kneeled during the national anthem. This got me thinking, are there any NBA players or coaches, past or present, that support Donald Trump? After hours of scouring the internet, I only found a handful of individuals. With that being said, let us look at the few. First up is Dennis Rodman. Dennis Rodman is one of the few NBA players in history that has supported Donald Trump openly. In 2016, he tweeted out, @RealDonaldTrump has been a great friend for many years. We don't need another politician, we need a businessman like Mr. Trump. Trump 2016. This shouldn't be very surprising, as he's a player that has always gone against the grain. This is the same dude who's friend with North Korean Supreme Leader Kim Jong-un. You know, the dude who's responsible for countless human rights violations and is obsessed with nukes. Over the past 4 years of Trump's administration though, Rodman's support for Trump has wavered. In 2018, he did say this.
Let's so you make have America make... great again.
All right.
You got it right there? You got it?
I got it. Thank you. So,
and acted as an American ambassador for Trump and Kim Jong-un. But in 2019, Rodman said this on a Sports Illustrated interview. I like Trump. I don't like him as president, but he's f***ing cool. As f***ing. So safe to say, Rodman's opinion on Trump has wavered these past couple years. Maybe Kim Jong-un got into his ears. We just know that the support that was once strongly there is gone. Next, we have Clyde Drexler, one of the greatest shooting guards to ever play the game. He's a Republican and is known to have exclusively donated to the Republican Party. This information is kind of old, but if you're donating to a party, you must heavily support them. So it is possible Clyde Drexler voted for Donald Trump. On the other hand, his allegiance may have changed when he's seen Trump as the leading Republican candidate, as I do believe being a Republican is different than being a Trump supporter. Clyde is, after all, African American, and that demographic tends not to be a big fan of Trump. Next, we have the sniper in Miami, Jimmy Neutron himself, Duncan Robinson. In the bubble, we've seen Robinson in the team huddles kneeling during the national anthem and sporting a BLM shirt. But did you know his girlfriend, Caroline Nava, is a Trump supporter, and a big one at that? This is her at a Trump rally, decked out in MAGA clothes. And the harsh and unfair reality is, her political views are a reflection on him. So I don't think it's a far-fetched assumption to assume Duncan Robinson voted Donald Trump. Next we have is Karl Malone, arguably the greatest power forward of all time and the s**t humans to ever play in the NBA. He is as country as you can get and is a heavy Republican, donating exclusively to the Republican Party. Karl Malone shows heavy signs he's a Donald Trump supporter. This is because just a couple years ago, he told the black community to stop using their race as an excuse for not taking responsibility for their own lives. And in an interview, snapped at an interviewer when talking about Trump and telling him to show some respect and call him President Trump. Just saying, doesn't seem like something a Joe Biden voter would be saying. Next we have is Latrell Sprewell, most notably remembered for getting suspended for 68 games for choking his coach.
Why, you little you devil libido!
Off the court, a questionable human. On the court, Latrell was a terrific player, making four all-star teams and always electrifying the crowd with his play. He openly supported Trump in his 2016 campaign, congratulating him on Twitter after he won the state of Nevada, then telling him he has his vote. Things may have changed by 2020, as he hasn't been vocal if he supports Trump, but it's not far-fetched to think he's still riding out. Then we have Jonathan Isaac, a player many casuals did not know, but now know. Why? Because he was the only NBA player in the bubble who refused to wear a BLM shirt and kneel during the national anthem. He became so popular for doing this, his jersey sales soared to number 2, just behind LeBron James. Isaac's reason for not wearing the shirt or kneeling was he felt it did not support Black lives. Then he gave a religious explanation. The Republican Party recently have been known to make political moves and decisions based on the Bible. So it's not a far-fetched thing to think Isaac would vote for the Republican Party as it aligns with his religious beliefs. Next, we have TNT analyst and 11-year vet Greg Anthony, a defensive specialist and a Republican. Anthony was one of the few individuals who were outspoken about being a Republican in his career, stating being a Republican wasn't real popular in the NBA locker room. Still isn't popular. But I was always strong in my beliefs and my philosophies. I didn't get caught up as much in what other people thought. I've caught a lot of heat for it through the years. But it's who I am. It's who I'm going to continue to be. And thank God I live in a country where I won't be penalized because I don't have the same belief or philosophy that other people do. Anthony even was a feature on an ad supporting 2012 presidential candidate Mitt Romney. It's safe to say the same support hasn't been there for Trump. But it makes you wonder, did he stick by Trump because of his beliefs and philosophies? Other individuals who possibly could have voted Trump are Sean Bradley, the 7'6" beast himself, and Chris Dudley. It's very likely both these individuals voted for Trump, as they were Republican representatives at one point in their life. Spencer Hawes was another one. His vote was apparently casted for Trump for his disdain towards Hillary Clinton. That's all the folks I've found who voted for Trump or who possibly could have voted for Trump. If you know any other ones, drop them in the comments below. This is Earn Your Ranks, where we only talk about ball. Signing off.